By the end of this video, you'll be an expert at graphing linear equations with slope-intercept formula, y equals mx plus b. Let's get started. So in order to graph linear equations with slope-intercept formula here, we need to have the right format. So that would be y equals 3x plus 1, for example, where the 3, that's the slope, and then the 1, that's the y-intercept. So once we put it in this format, it's pretty straightforward. B, that's the y-intercept. So the y-intercept is 1. That's where we're going to cross the y-axis. So we have a y-intercept of 1. We find 1. That's the first point. The slope, that's 3. But it's helpful to think of it as 3 over 1. That way, we can call the 3 rise and the 1 run. So now we go to the y-intercept. We go up 1, 2, 3. That's the rise and over 1. That's our second point. From there, we go up 1, 2, 3, and over 1. And you can see these are all in a line. You can also go down, and then in the opposite direction, down 1, 2, 3, then over 1. Down 1, 2, 3, and over 1. All these points are on a line. We put a line through it, put some arrows to show it goes to infinity, and we're done. This is the graph for y equals 3x plus 1 using slope-intercept formula. So pause and give this one a try. So we can graph these pretty quickly using slope-intercept formula, y equals mx plus b. But what if you're given something like y equals 3x? In that case, we can just assume that b is 0. We could just put plus 0. We have our slope, m, which is 3. We call it 3 over 1, rise over run, and we add our points. We rise 1, 2, 3, go over 1, rise 1, 2, 3, go over 1, and we can keep adding points, and that'll give us the line for y equals 3x. But what if we're given an equation that's not in slope-intercept formula? So here we have y minus 2x equals 4. We need to get this in slope-intercept formula. So let's add 2x to each side, plus 2x, plus 2x. Now these cancel out. We have y equals 4 plus 2x. We can fix that. That's y equals 2x plus 4. And then we're back to slope-intercept formula, and it's pretty easy to graph. So pause and give this one a try. So here we'll subtract 6 from each side. We end up with, which is now in slope-intercept formula. And if we want to graph this, we should note that we don't have anything in front of x, so that's just 1, and we can call that 1 over 1 to give us rise over run. 1 over 1 is really just 1, so we haven't changed anything. And then the graph looks like this. Sometimes you'll be given a fraction for the slope. How do you manage that? In this case, our y-intercept, that's 2 right here, so we could just put 2, and then rise over run, 1 over 2. Go up 1 over 2. So it's really the same process using slope-intercept formula y equals mx plus b. Let's look at one last one. What happens when we have a negative here in our equation? We know that the y-intercept, that's going to be 1. So we can just put that out there. And the slope, we could put negative 2 over 1. And that wouldn't change the value. We'd still have negative 2x. But now again, we have rise over run. And in this case, we're going to rise negative 2. But that means going in the opposite direction since it's negative. So we're going to go down 1, 2, and then over 1. Then we'll do it again. Down 1, 2, over 1. And you can see our graph for y equals negative 2x plus 1 is done pretty much the same way as the others. So pause and give this one a try. So I hope you remembered that since we didn't have anything for b, we called it 0, and this is the graph we end up for y equals minus 4x. If you need more practice or some help using a table of values to find the graphs for linear equations, there are links at the end of this video. This is Dr. B graphing linear equations using y equals mx plus b, slope-intercept formula. Thanks for watching.